change. And on the right column, I had how that would be expressed mathematically. So lots of times we talk about the velocity of a car after traveling for 1 hour is 50 miles per hour. So how does that translate mathematically? S of t always refers to your distance. So the rate of change would be a ds over dt. That would be 50, and then t is 1. Comes from the fact that it's been traveling for an hour. Very, very common rates of change problems are volume problems. Water pumps into a swimming pool at a rate of 10 cubic meters per hour. So we're talking about the volume of the pool, and it's increasing by 10 cubic meters per hour, so that's your dV over dt, and that's positive because it's being pumped in. It would be pumped out, that would be a negative rate. Another one, we don't deal with these quite as much. They're not as common as the volume problems, but we will deal with this on Monday. A meter is a volume rate of 25 revolutions per minute. I put a little note here because we will get to use this information that we're going to do with 25 radians. Because you need to express the rate of change at this angle in radians, not in revolutions. You've got to be able to revolutions in radians to multiply by 25. So we look at some of those on Monday. But what we're going to look at right now is we're going to look at example number, whatever the next one is in my screen decides to change to. This is that intro problem that I gave you. Water is being drained out of a conical tank. The height is changing at a rate of negative 0.2 feet per minute because it's draining out. The height is decreasing. The radius is also decreasing because you're talking about the cone, as you go down, the radius is getting smaller. So it's negative 0.1 feet per minute. The question is, what is the rate of change in the volume when the radius is 1 foot and the height is 2 feet? Now, I think it's very helpful with these problems to write down what you know, what you don't know, and what equations you're going to be using. Okay, so the height is changing at a rate of negative 0.2 feet per minute. So that is the dH over dt is negative 0.2. Now I'm going to leave the units off because I'm just going to end up plugging stuff into our problem. The radius dr over dt is changing. It's changing, so that's dr over dt. That's negative 0.1. We know two other things. We know when the radius is 1 foot, so r is 1 and height is 2. The question is, what is the rate of change in the volume? So that's our unknown. dv over dt is what we're looking for. So we're talking about the volume of this cone. We need the equation. For the volume of a cone, the equation for a volume of a cone is 1/3 pi r squared h. No. What happened on the AP exam last year was it was a question about a funnel. The funnel was not a cone. The funnel was created by a solid revolution, which they should have known because there is always a question like that on the exam, and there wasn't one yet, so they should have known that that was the question that they were supposed to do that on, and they didn't. A little bitter about that, but it's okay. It's okay. Apparently, they weren't the only ones. Every AP calculus student in America forgot. Not every single one of them, but apparently it was all over Twitter about what the heck's going on with this funnel problem. Yeah. Okay, so let's look at solving this, okay? So we need to take the derivative of our volume formula, dv over dt. We don't need any more room than that. Okay, here's the thing. A lot of times they will give them to you. If they don't give them to you, they assume that you know, like, the volume of a prism. Well, usually it's the ones that involve the 1/3 that they will give to you. Okay, Any prism, it's the area of the base times the height. Okay, so like a rectangular prism, it's the area of the base times the height. A triangular prism, area of the base times the height. We'll do several problems like this, guys. We'll talk about it. Okay, so the 1/3 pi there is a constant. Just keep it in front. R squared times h, we're going to use the product rule. So first times the derivative of the second gives us r squared dh over dt. Plus the derivative of the first, 2r, don't forget this part, dr over dt times the second, h. Keep the constant part in front, the 1/3 pi goes in front. R squared h is a product rule. So, because we have to do, these are all in respect to time, so we have to do implicit differentiation with all of our variables. Okay? So, let's plug in what we know. R is 1. dH over dt is negative 0.2. R is 1, dr over dt is negative 0.1, and h is 2. This is the product rule. So we've got negative 0.2 plus negative 0.4. 2 times negative 0.1 times 2, 4 times negative 0.1 is negative 0.4. So at this point, I'm going to plug it into our calculators to get a decimal approximation. And mine's going to take forever to come up. Yes? Particle motion? Okay. Yeah, and I've forgotten about that, so I'll work on that this weekend and let you know on Monday. Where is my calculator? Why is it not here? Because it's a constant multiple. So the constant multiples always come down and then multiply by the greater the variable. If that was plus 1/3 pi, it would be 0. But because it's times. And that would be, what were our units? Feet. Feet per minute. Cubic feet per minute, because we're talking about the volume change. Okay? Okay, just as a little reminder, when you're doing the AP exam, you always want to be accurate to 3 decimal places. Okay, don't round. We call it truncating. Just write the first 3 numbers. And you don't have to worry about rounding. Okay, don't worry about rounding here. Okay, so yesterday, when we introduced this problem, I asked, what do y'all think? Does the rate of change in volume depend on the values of the height and the radius? So is the volume changing at the same rate at the top of the cone as it is at the bottom of the cone? So we just did it kind of close to the bottom when the radius is 1 and the height is 2. Well, let's try this. Let's see. What happens if the radius is 3 and the height is 6? Well, we've already done the derivative. We've just got to plug in some different values here. So let's do that. 1/3 pi. Why does it keep doing that? Okay, so the radius, what did I say, was 3 squared. Now the rate of change is still the same. Plus 2 times the radius of 3 times the dr over dt times 8. Yes. So yes, it matters greatly. Okay, it matters greatly. The rate of change in volume is very different. Now something's not. Something's off about that. Yeah, I missed my -0.1. Okay, that is definitely not right. Okay, this makes more sense. Okay, because the volume is decreasing, that other answer didn't make sense. Because the other answer was positive, that would mean the volume is decreasing. Yes, I missed the -0.1. I hope there was spazzing out there. So this makes more sense. -5.654 cubic feet per minute. So it's actually the volume is changing at a greater rate at the top than it is at the bottom. That would be at the top. Which kind of makes sense because you're talking about you have a greater volume, so it is changing at a greater rate at the top than at the bottom. Yeah.
I told you, most of the time we'll give it to you. Okay. Most of the time we'll give it to you. I'm going to hold that. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
It's getting there. It's thinking real hard. Okay, Jessica, what is your question?
Is the first
because every time you, when you're doing these problems, every time you take the derivative of a variable, you got to multiply by the derivative of that variable with respect to whatever you're doing. This is all, because this is all in respect to time, every time you take the derivative of a variable, you got to add that to the end. If this was respect to the radius, then no, we wouldn't have that, but it's with respect to time. Yes.
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 Okay. Let's try one that's just a little bit easier, actually, because we're just talking about a circle. Okay? We have a pedal that's dropped into a compound that's causing ripples in the form of concentric circles. Concentric just means they have